The index problem is you'll say, yeah, sure, but I go from CUL, I connect to some website. How do they know that's me behind that computer? Well, because there is no anonymity in the internet, really. There is none. There's a lot of ways people can find out, for example, that you know, your computer is yours. For example, you have a unique browser footprint. So there's one app you could go, like maybe after the lectures, called Panopticlick. Just Google for that. And it's going to show you, based on your browser configuration, how unique you are. You know, that's just basically how unique you really are. And then we did something else. We said, OK, let's look at social media. And this is an experiment we did at ICSI. And I said before, let's do that at ICSI. We were like, OK, so people are kind of, you know, Colbert said, be careful what you post on Facebook. In fact, Obama said that too, and so on. But we were like, OK, so here's one thing that's interesting. Yelp actually requires ID from you if you want to be a power user, because they don't want a small business to just review themselves all the time, right? So what happens is you go and have to fax in your California ID or whatever ID you have. So that means Yelp power users are actually confirmed identities, like legally confirmed identities. So we're like, OK, but my assumption was, if you're legally like confirmed identity on one social media website, I bet you you can't be anonymous anymore on other social media websites, because you can correlate, right? So just because you're anonymous on one website doesn't mean you're actually anonymous on others. No, it's stronger than that. When you're not anonymous on one website, you're not anonymous at all anymore. And so this is how what we did. So the initial idea that we have was, OK, you go to Yelp, and you review that restaurant, and you say, oh, I had this awesome spaghetti carbonara. And of course, before you do that on Yelp, because that's maybe what you do like the next day, you go on Twitter and tweet your friends, oh, I'm having this awesome spaghetti carbonara at this restaurant. And the question we asked is, what's the chance that somebody has around the same time the same dish twice, three times, four times, five times, right? Because think about it. If you go to a restaurant and have that dish, and the next day you go to another restaurant and have another dish, that combination is so unique already that you're basically identifiable, right? And if you do this for a long enough time, three times, four times, five times, six times, you know, then you're completely identifiable, really, because that combination makes you super unique. But at some point, while this was clear, we decided, no, actually, let's forget about what was posted. So we went one step further. We said, you can post about what you want. We ignore that information. All we take is the location and the time, right? So you post something at this restaurant at the time, and then you post something on Yelp about that location at a later time. What does that already do for your anonymity? Well, it pretty much destroys it. So we have, basically, you could post just spaces, right? So the content doesn't even give you away. It's just your footprint that gives you away. And so we did this experiment with about 10,000 posts. And it was, I think, 1,000 Twitter accounts. And then 40%, 60% of Yelp account matched. And then we also did this against Flickr, because people take photos. And then 40% of Flickr account matched. And you know, while 40%, 60% isn't 100%, first of all, this is one experiment. And second, the more you post, the easier it's going to be. And also, we didn't take into account the content yet, right? So we didn't actually look at the spaghetti carbonara. And if we did, I'm pretty sure it would be even better. So basically, if that already, if posting spaces on Twitter gives you away, then basically it means there's no anonymity, right? So be aware, nothing is anonymous, even if the website claims so, right? Especially, you know, dating websites or Craigslist or these kind of websites, they will say, we don't give out information. Yeah, they don't, but you do yourself explicitly, so implicitly. So basically, just never assume anonymity. Don't do anything that you wouldn't do in public, right? It's basically internet equals, you know, real world.